This video will show you how to set up and program your Ascend Smart Timer with the Intermatic Connect app. The first step is to download the Intermatic Connect mobile application from the App Store or Google Play and open it. If the app doesn't take you directly to the login screen, click Login at the top right of the display. The next screen will ask you to log in or create an Intermatic Connect cloud account. You can skip this step if you don't have access to the email account that you want to use to control the timer. For this example, we do have access, so we will choose Create Account at the bottom of the screen. The next screen will ask you to enter your email address and create a password with at least 8 characters, including uppercase and lowercase letters, a number, and a special symbol. To accept the privacy policy and terms and conditions, check the box and click Continue. A 6-digit access code will be emailed to the address you provided. Minimize the app and find this code in your email program. You can copy and paste the access code or type it in manually. Now choose Create Account at the bottom of the screen. The app will search for devices. If it does not find any, you will need to establish a connection to the timer. Minimize the app and go to your phone's Wi-Fi settings. A list of available devices will appear. The Ascend's SSID number will be a long string of characters beginning with 7DT and will be shown on the Ascend devices screen. Choose this as your network. It will ask you for a password. Type in Intermatic in all lowercase letters, then click Join. You are now connected to the Ascend local access point. A PIN code will appear on the Ascend device screen. If a PIN code doesn't appear, click on the Timer's menu button. You will have to go through the manual setup steps, but just choose the defaults by pushing the On/Off Enter button, because these settings will be synced to your mobile device later. Once manual setup is complete, the timer will prompt you to set up a schedule. Choose No. You are now at the home screen. Press the menu button again and navigate to Info using the up and down arrows. Now press the On/Off Enter button and navigate to Wireless. To view the PIN code, press On/Off Enter again. Once the PIN is displayed, navigate back to the Connect app on your mobile device and click on the plus icon. Choose the type of device you are connecting, which in this case is the Ascend timer. You may have to refresh by pulling down on the screen. The app will display New Timer and show you that you're connected through the local access point. If there's a firmware upgrade available, press the Firmware Upgrade box to ensure compatibility with the latest app version. A window will pop up asking for the PIN code. Type in the numbers that appear on the Ascend device screen and click OK. Once the PIN is validated, you can click Upgrade Now to download and install the latest firmware. Your timer will reboot. This usually takes about 1 minute. When prompted, reconnect to the timer's network. Go into your mobile device's Wi-Fi settings and reconnect with the timer using the same SSID number used earlier. Go back to the Connect app. A progress bar will show the upgrade status. This may take a few minutes. Once the firmware upgrade is complete, you will again be prompted to reconnect to the timer. Minimize the Connect app, go into your mobile device's Wi-Fi settings, and reconnect to the timer's SSID. Now go back to the Connect app. The timer will reboot. Once rebooted, you may have to hit the refresh button on the home screen for the app to recognize the upgraded timer. You should once again see your timer displayed as New Timer on the app's home screen. Tap on this text box. The next screen will ask you to name your timer. This will help if you have multiple timers or if you wish to sync the Ascend to a Google Home or Alexa device. For this example, we'll name the timer Front Door and then press Next. After the name is set, the next screen will ask for the local time and location of the Ascend. The easiest option is to choose to sync these settings with your phone. Next, you can create a schedule for the timer by choosing from the templates shown, or you can create a custom schedule later. We will choose on in the mornings and evenings. The final setup screen will ask if you want to connect to a network or if you want to finish the setup. Choose Connect to Network if you would like to access the timer on your local area network. A list will appear showing all available networks. Choose your network and type in the password. Tap Connect. You will be prompted to connect your mobile device to the network as well. Go into your device's Wi-Fi settings and connect to your network. Now go back to the Connect app for device setup. This may take a few minutes. Because you are logged into your Intermatic cloud account, the Ascend will also sync to your cloud account so you can access the timer remotely. This will take a few minutes. Once setup is complete, press the button to view the schedule. A weekly schedule screen will appear, showing you the times that the device will be on, indicated by a blue line. Clicking on the expansion arrow to the right side of any of the days will show exact on and off times. The schedule we chose, on mornings and evenings, turns the timer on every morning at 5 a.m. and off every morning at sunrise, which for this location and time of year is at 7:07 a.m. The timer will turn on again in the evenings at sunset and off at 10 p.m. We can modify these settings by clicking directly on each event in the list. For this example, let's change the morning off time from sunrise to a specific time, 8 a.m. Click on the morning off event to bring up its settings. Change the setting from sunrise to time. Click in the box that shows the current off time and choose a new time with the dial below. For this example, we will choose 8 a.m. and press Done. Now click Save. The event will update and be reflected in the new schedule. Now the timer will turn on every morning at 5 a.m. and turn off at 8 a.m. before turning on again in the evenings. You can also delete events by clicking on the specific event and choosing the delete icon in its settings screen. For this example, let's delete all events from the schedule. To set a new event, click on the plus icon on the upper right of the display. You can choose from a template or create your own schedule with the basic scheduling option. Select basic scheduling. For this example, we will have the timer turn on Monday through Friday at sunset. So deselect Saturday and Sunday and choose on as the event action. Under time, press the sunset option. You can offset this time up to plus or minus 120 minutes. But for this example, we will keep it at sunset. Click Save. The schedule now reflects the on time. But because no off event has been set, the blue line is continuous. Click on the plus icon to set the off event. Again, choose Basic Scheduling. For this example, we will choose for the timer to turn off Tuesday through Saturday at 8 a.m. So deselect Sunday and Monday and choose 8 a.m. as the off time. Now click Save. The new event is now shown in the schedule, with the timer turning on at sunset Monday through Friday and turning off at 8 a.m. the next morning. Now click on the Home button in the top left of the display. Your timer front door is listed, showing that you are connected through the cloud. The next event is shown in the display as well as on the Ascend screen. From the app, you can remotely turn the timer on and off by pressing on the power button icon. You can also choose between auto, manual, or random mode. Auto mode allows all pre-programmed schedules as well as manual overrides. Manual mode disables all programmed schedules and only allows manual operation through the timer or app. Random mode will adjust the programmed on and off times within plus or minus 15 minutes for security. And you're done! You now have access to your Ascend settings and scheduling both inside and outside your home. If you have any questions or need help at any step in the process, you can call or email technical support at the contact information listed on the screen. And be sure to check out our other videos on YouTube or visit our webpage for more tutorials.